Good morning everyone. This is standard 7. We are going to read about the chapter 4, heat, and this is second video. In this video we will read about the transfer of heat. Now first of all, what is transfer of heat? The transfer of heat, the flow of heat from a body at higher temperature to another body or to another part of the same body at lower temperature is called transfer of heat. Means the body which are in the higher temperature, the temperature will go from higher to lower. That is, heat is getting transferred. As you know that when we heat the vessel, when we put the vessel in a gas stove or in the fire, what happened? The water in the vessel becomes hot after some times. Okay, how it happens? The heat is transferring from higher temperature to a little lower temperature. Okay, now in this we will read about the mode of heat transfer. As we know that the heat is transferred from one body to another body by different ways. What are the ways we have to read? First one is conduction, second one is convection, third one is radiation. Now we are going to read about the conduction. This is the mode of transfer of heat. The process of transfer of heat in a body from the hotter end to a colder end without any actual movement of molecules of the body. Okay, I am giving the example, when one end of the iron rod is held in the hand and the other end is heated, you will feel after some time your hand is getting heated. The end held in the hand soon becomes warmer till we are unable to hold the rod. We will throw the rod as we are getting too much heat. When one end of the iron rod is heated, the molecules there absorb the heat energy and begin to vibrate rapidly. Okay, these molecules in turn cause the neighboring molecules in turn causes their neighboring molecules to vibrate. This process continues along the iron rod and energy is transferred from the hot part to the cold part of the iron rod. Okay, now the most important thing is two conditions for the heat to be conducted from one body to another body. The first one, the two bodies should be in contact. If two bodies should be in contact, then only the heat is getting transferred. Second one condition is that their temperature should be different. If both the bodies should have same temperature, then there would be a very difficult to transfer the heat. The heat will not transfer if the difference in the temperature in both the system or both the rods, then the actual movement of transfer of heat takes. In this conductor we are going to read about the good and the bad conductor of heat. What is the good conductor and bad conductor of heat? Okay, good conductor of heats are those material which allow the heat to pass through them quickly are called good conductor of heat. As we know that the metals are good conductor of heat, like silver, like copper, like aluminium, iron, and many alloys like brass and stainless steel are the good conductor of heat. Okay, now what is the bad conductor of heat? As you know, the substance which do not conduct heat easily or in which the rate of conduction is very very slow. Now what are the examples? The wood, leather, asbestos, paper, some gases are there, air and liquid except the mercury. Mercury is the metal which conduct the heat. And the example of bad, the another name of bad conductor of heat is insulator. They are also called insulators. Okay, one example is insulating handles are there. Okay, we will give examples for the good conductor of heat. Okay, the cookers or the frying pans are having a handle made up of metals. Okay,